This is definitely the best part of my morning because I get to hang out with him. It's nice and quiet and he's smiling at me. Are you smiling? Hey, cutie. It's just amazing to have reached this point after so many years and have this gorgeous little bubba. You're smiling. You're so relaxed. It's because it's the weekend, I can tell. I found myself perpetually single going on dates, right? And nothing scares somebody off enough than in the first date, one of your first, you know, questions is, do you want to be a dad? And in the gay world, not that many guys do. You know, I could just see the lights going out, right, in their eyes. And I'd be like, here we go, another date gone sour. And I was putting a lot of pressure on myself to meet someone, and I was putting a lot of pressure on everyone else.
He's the first single dad in Victoria to have a biological baby via surrogate.
After a grueling 3.5-year process, which now has IVF experts calling for reform.
Contrary to popular belief in the room, I actually wanted to be a dad as a gay man. I decided to go surrogacy alone, well, firstly because adoption in Australia is a super hard ordeal. And as a single man nearing 40s, I'm not even sure I would have been able to do it. The surrogacy journey lasted from start to finish 3.5 years. My first three surrogates unfortunately had to pull out for various personal reasons. And each one of those journeys spanned from anywhere from 4 months to 6 months. There's so much excitement and joy when somebody offers to carry a baby for you. And then boom, when that journey comes to an end, it's soul destroying, it's crushing. And I think that's when it would have been nice to have had a partner to lean and have a cry on their shoulder. It was really just myself that I was relying on, you know, late at night, early hours of the morning.
Hey, here you are. Hey, girls. Hey. Hey, beautiful. Oh, look who's here, look who's here.
Shaun and I first met through a surrogacy support group. I was pregnant as a surrogate myself at that time when we first met, and we just hit it off. My first impression was that he was full of life, he was enthusiastic, he knew exactly what he wanted. And when I saw the trouble he was having and the roadblocks that were popping up for him in his journey to become a father, I got to a point where I realised he was a friend who needed something that I knew I could provide. I have my own 3 biological children. There are another 11 children from eggs that I donated that were carried by the parents or other surrogates. And then there are another 2 children who I was a traditional surrogate for. So in total, there are 16 children that are genetically from my eggs. And then plus Eli, who I carried, but who's not related to me. I was lucky enough that I didn't have troubles with my fertility. I had eggs to spare. I was able to be pregnant without any negative side effects. So that was a gift that I was able to give that brought joy to other people, and their joy then brought me joy. Being that surrogacy is altruistic in Australia, meaning that surrogates don't get paid for doing it, what a surrogate gets out of it, it's really about the good feelings. It's the touchy-feely stuff. It's the relationship you develop with the parents. It's the good feeling you get in yourself, knowing that you are doing a good thing for somebody else. Being a surrogate for Shaun has brought us closer in a lot of ways. We've shared a lot of experiences through the surrogacy journey that we wouldn't have had a chance to share otherwise as friends. So it's definitely added to our relationship.
We have food.
Shaun was a great help and support for me. He spent a lot of time developing a deeper relationship with my children. He really made an effort to get to spend time with my kids and myself. He came to every appointment at the hospital. He was there for the birth, so he was very involved the whole way out through. The type of relationship I imagine having with Eli is, I guess, maybe a bit of an auntie type role. I think mine and Shaun's friendship will continue as it was in a lot of ways, just with this extra level of depth to it. So I think all of us combined will just be a nice extended family for Eli.
Now that Eli's been born, one of the things I can honestly say that I didn't expect was just how hard it is. I think for anyone who's been sleep deprived for a number of weeks in a row, it's tiring, and you find yourself exhausted. I'm still working part-time, so I'm juggling being a dad and juggling, you know, newish relationship as well, and having Bubba in the mix. I don't think society has really registered the notion of single, you know, fathers at this point. It's not often you see males in this role. Some of the comments that I've seen about how's a man going to raise a child on his own, or, you know, how can you strip a bubs away from the biological mother, for example. So there's been a fair whack of that kind of criticism that's come through.
When people see people like Shaun doing it on their own, they'll realise that it's something that they can do, that they don't need to have a partner in their lives if they want to become a father.
One of the great things that's come out of it is it's been an inspiration to a lot of people. So all of a sudden, we're getting people coming out, giving their well wishes and saying congratulations and thanks for being an inspiration. So it's actually been a beautiful surprise knowing that I can inspire other people to reach for their dreams. Surrogacy within Australia is ridiculously hard, but I love the idea that if I did it locally, my future child or children would have a relationship with the birth mother and would be a family as such, a new age kind of family. I'd love to have another Bubba for Eli. I'd love nothing more than to give this little boy the opportunity to have a brother or a sister to play with and connect with. I pinch myself when I think about where I'm at right now. Like 3 years ago, if someone had said, hey, by the way, you're gonna have a partner who you absolutely love and adore, a gorgeous son who's outstanding, and another dog as well, I would have been, nah, that's just, you know, too much. I anticipated just being a single dad, okay? So everything's fallen into place so beautifully.